Friday, September 25th, 2009, and this is your Daily Dose. We're going to get right in on that DAP. This is the Daily Advancement for Patients activity, and today's DAP, what I'd like for you to do is if you could take your time and send an email to Jack, the Hemperer himself. You can send those emails to his wife, Jeannie. The email address is over my shoulder. You can see it right up there on the board. Jeannie Herrera at yahoo.com. And that's J-E-A-N-N-I-E-H-E-R-E-R at yahoo.com. So let's send our best well wishes to a recovery for Jack. And also, anything you'd like to say to help his wife get through this trying time. I'm sure she'd like to see some warm words as well. But take your time today, send an email, let Jack know what he's done for you. I know he's done a lot for me, and I'm going to take time to do that today as well. I'm also going to take time right now to wish a happy 86th birthday to my grandfather, who I'm named after. We don't share the same middle name, but he's James Parsons, and I'm James Parsons as well. So I just wanted to say happy birthday, Grandpa. I love you. Hopefully we'll get out there to see you soon. I know it's been a long time, but I miss you. Can't wait to see you again. Hope you enjoy your birthday. I know your son's out there. My dad's out there. I hope you guys have a great time. Enjoy yourselves. Do it up. All right. Next thing we're going to get into, the quotes. The first quote I came with today is one that I think about all the time, and it's by, and I know I'm going to say his name, I believe it's Dean Acheson, and it's, "Always remember, the future comes one day at a time." And then this next quote is from Robert Gallagher, and it's more like a comedic spin on life, and it says, "Change is inevitable, except from a vending machine." I brought in another one because, you know, over the next few weeks, you know, we're getting ready to do some work here. And I always like to come with, the ounce of prevention's worth a pound of cure. But here's one that comes from General George Patton. And it says, "A pint of sweat saves a gallon of blood." And then last but not least, and this is the thought for today as far as the quotes go, as far as medical marijuana advancement for patients go in the state of Nevada, difficulty is the excuse history never accepts. And that was by Edward Murrow. It doesn't matter how difficult it is to get what we want. Safe access now. History won't accept the fact if we just let 70 more years go on. Through time, we've seen the oppression of cannabis. We've seen the prohibitionists and their approach. It's not working. Let's not be the generation that waits another 50, 60, 70 years to make a common sense thing happen. The reason groups such as Marijuana Policy Project can make $10,000 challenges with rhetorical questions they already know the answers to, and the reason that the Hemperer himself has a book with a $100,000 challenge in it, it's because the challenges can't be beat. That's just the way it is. It's just like gravity. If I hold this bottle up and I let go, boom, falls right to the ground. There's no refuting the facts that have been placed out there by MPP Nevada or the global facts put out there through the Emperor Wears No Clothes. You have to honestly, this is the honest truth. If you're an elected official and you go, "Oh, well, it's not that easy, James, there's a bigger picture." Bullshit. It's a real simple decision that needs to be made. Politician or not, kickbacks from this industry or political donations from this, squash all that. That doesn't mean anything. The fact is, when you have an individual human being with a condition that has something recommended by a doctor to treat it, that's it. Even if the person isn't a doctor, if they just use it and find out, That's just a law of nature. We've come very far, patients in Nevada. From 2001 to 2009, there wasn't a lot of us that walked around rocking the plastic. But since March of this year, we're looking at almost at least 1,600 people that I know of, just because of the numbers on them. So let's do the math real quick. 1,600 times 50. Holy cow, that's 80 G's. 80 G's for that state office in 6 months. But, oh wait, what happens when those 1,600 come back with their 150? Let's see what happens there. Boom, ba boom, boom. Boom, ba doom, boom. Boom, ba doom, boom. Busting out my 8th grade math real quick. Wow. Another 240K. So we're looking at $320,000 for what amounts to a few pieces of paperwork. You know, a packet of papers. Packets of papers. I know this much. It doesn't take 320K to produce the packet of paperwork and hire the people that run the office. I know there's a surplus there. Why is our program so expensive still? I mean, there's just so many things that we've had it difficult on, but you can see the future and where it's going. And the only way it's going to get to where it isn't difficult is if we, the patients, speak up and make it that way. Don't call up your friend in your neighbor who's a patient and say, hey, did you see Preach's video today? Did you see the Daily Dose? Man, that was off. No, talk to the people that don't know. Talk to the police officers you don't know. That anxiety attack that you have when you're a patient, everybody needs to know, whether they're a police officer, fire department, church pastor. I don't care who they are. Cannabis has been proven to be safe and effective, non-toxic, non-lethal. Worst case scenario, you try it, you don't like it. It's just like that strawberry quick. I tried it once, I didn't like it. Didn't use it anymore. Well, James, it's not that simple. Yes, it is. Everything in life is a series of choices. You can make poor choices or you can make good choices. It's completely up to you. I have a choice every time I pick up Mountain Dew to actually drink water instead. Well, today I chose to drink water. Doesn't mean I can't run out and make a mistake and grab a Mountain Dew later. Just means that right now, when I was confronted with that choice, I made a good one. Today, don't forget, email Jeannie and Jack. Email address is right there also. Don't forget your quotes. Remember the most important one. Difficulty is the excuse. History never accepts. And then also I'd like to announce there's a possibility that the office will be closed on Monday. I will probably be leaving town. I have to go to meet with some potential associates or affiliates that would like to work together here in Nevada to help make life for patients better. I also want to thank whoever that wonderful person was. Sour Diesel, one of the best. I love it. It's great. One of the best to produce. A little on the pricey end, but it's still wonderful. It's a great way to start the Friday. This was Friday, September 25th, 2009. Don't forget your DAP. Don't forget your quotes. Don't forget the potential for Monday being the office being closed while I'm out of town. I might still be in California, like I said, handling business. I will try to get a video up on Saturday and Sunday this week. It looks like YouTube's going to cooperate a little better. We'll see today. I got the 10-minute video, and if this one goes up, then it'll be the green light to go ahead and upload the Canna Butter DVD finally. All right, I know you guys are getting tired of hearing that, but I mean it. I promise. We'll see what happens. This was Friday, the 25th. Everybody have a great weekend, and don't forget to check me out Saturday and Sunday of this week. I'll do my best to get videos up. Have a great weekend. Don't forget, email Jack and his wife. Wish him the best.